Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to discuss about introduction to Salesforce. Before starting, let me share you how you can search my channel on YouTube. You can search me by my name, and here you can watch various Salesforce related videos. So the introduction first slide contains various points related to Salesforce. So first point says Salesforce is the world's most popular CRM system. So CRM basically stands for customer relationship management. Its headquarters is in San Francisco with more than 82,000 plus companies and 1 lakh plus customers rely on this dynamic web-based low-cost CRM platform. It was founded by Marc Benioff. And last point says Salesforce CRM provides a complete solution for marketing, sales, services, partner management, and community management. So these are the key features that are related to Salesforce. Moving to next slide. So here the CRM overview is written. So CRM stands for customer relationship management. Broadly defined, CRM is a strategy for managing a company's interaction with clients and sales prospects and ensuring the connect sustains throughout the relation. So this is the key feature of CRM. Now you can understand CRM with the help of this diagram. So the point one says acquire, point two says retain, and point three says extend. So first we need to acquire the business, then we need to retain that business, and then we need to extend that business. Then inner circle says information technology, innovation, marketing operations, shareholder value creation. So these are some key points. With the help of these key points, CRM manages customers. So acquire, retain, and extend. This is the key philosophy of CRM. Now, the CRM, the results till now. So two main types of CRM systems are available. First is on-premise. Those are also known as traditional systems. And second one is on-demand. Those are also known as cloud-based systems. So you can understand it with the help of this diagram, how technology changed. So in 1960s, we used mainframe. In 1980s, we used client-server systems or architectures, and today's we are using cloud computing applications. So there are various companies available in the market which are providing cloud computing applications and infrastructure. So today's scenario is based on on-demand cloud-based system. So Salesforce is related to that cloud-based system. So here you can see 3 points are listed related to Salesforce CRM benefits. So first point says it provides low cost, low risk, cloud-based solution software services to buy. Second point says complete solution, which includes feature-rich solution for marketing, sales, service, partner management, and community management. And last point says fast result because it drains resources on high value, low cost, and focus on innovation. So Salesforce continuously focuses on innovation. That's why it is popular in the market. So these are some popular products which are provided by Salesforce. So these are individual clouds which provide various solutions for the customers in real-time scenarios. So first is Sales Cloud, second is Service Cloud. So Sales Cloud is basically providing Salesforce automation and CRM. Service Cloud is providing customer service and help desk software. Third is Marketing Cloud, which provides digital marketing platform. Fourth is Community Cloud, which provides community collaboration software. Then Wave Analytics, which provides business intelligence software. Then App Cloud, which provides cloud app development platform. Then IoT Cloud, which provides connected device platform. Then Commerce Cloud, which provides digital commerce, point of sales, and other management. So these are popular products which are right now available by Salesforce so that you can implement your problems in better way with the help of these clouds. The next slide says how Salesforce helps. So basically, Salesforce implementation is divided into two parts. First is clicks and second is code. So force.com cloud platform focuses on 80% clicks and 20% code. And whereas coding based systems works on 20% clicks and 80% code. So because of less code, this Salesforce cloud platform is more popular as compared to other platforms. Because if we have less code, then it will be easy to manageable and understandable. Then next, you can understand the coding and a declarative part with the help of this diagram. So first block says declarative and second says programmatic. So let me take, so here you can see this is the declarative block and this one is the programmatic block. So all these features are related to declarative and these features are related to programmatic, right? So on declarative part, if we focus on user interface, so in declarative we have applications, tabs, page layouts, record types. On programmatic part, we have Visual Force pages, web controls, force.com sites. Then second is business logic. For declarative part, we have workflow, validation rule, assignment rules. For programmatic, we have Visual Force controls, Apex, web services, APIs. Then third is data model. So on declarative part, we have objects, fields, and relationships. On programmatic part, we have web services, API, and metadata API. So if we focus on declarative, so it provides simplicity and speed. If we focus on programmatic, it provides control plus flexibility. So both have their own advantages. So as per the requirement, we can choose either declarative or programmatic. So somewhere declarative is beneficial and somewhere we need to use programmatic so that we can fully utilize the features provided by the Salesforce. Now we need to discuss how Salesforce is useful. So you can see the first point. It says Salesforce.com offers a conclusive concept to deliver an easy to use CRM software as a service using a dynamic, scale-free cloud computing approach. Second point says, this satisfies the customer demand and leverages cost benefit for the customer of Salesforce.com. Next point says, Salesforce does a lot to create a productive, collaborative CRM environment. Next point says, the success of Salesforce.com is based on an excellent management, a clear company strategy and a business model which uses cutting edge technology combined with a developer community and an easy to use platform which is delivered in a very cost effective manner. So these are some usefulness of Salesforce. Because of that, you can opt Salesforce to manage your business requirement so that you can have cost effective solution for your business requirement. Now we need to see the user interface. So the basics of an app's user interface. So here are two different user interfaces are available. So first is the full Salesforce site as accessed from your desktop computer. And second one is the mobile application. So you can see this diagram, apps in the full site. So if you are accessing Salesforce from your desktop, so it will look like this. So this is a picture of Salesforce Classic. Right now we are also using Salesforce Lightning. So this playlist is related to Salesforce Classic, or you can say this video is related to Salesforce Classic. If you want to see Salesforce Lightning, so you can watch my another video related to Salesforce Lightning experience. So here you can see various help text are shown with red lines. So here you can see home lead account, contacts, opportunities, reports, dashboard, document, products, and forecast. So this line says these are the tabs. Then we have customized page, tab, Carol, then www.grandhotels.com. So these are some hyperlinks. And then this line says these type, industry, description, employees, annual revenue, and above account, owner account name, parent account, and below billing address, shipping address. These all are fields, right? So this way, through these red lines, these are categorized and they are indicating what are these. So in this slide, tabs, hyperlinks, and fields are described with these lines. Then this is the Salesforce one mobile application. So if you are accessing Salesforce in mobile application, so it will look like this. So you need to download Salesforce one mobile application in your phone, then you can access Salesforce with the help of Salesforce one mobile application. So here also you can see menu items, links, and fields are available. So this is all about introduction to Salesforce. I hope you understood something related to Salesforce by watching this video. If you want to follow more Salesforce related videos, you can search me on YouTube by my name. Thank you for watching this video.